Is man destined to become obsolete? Can he easily be replaced by the super-efficient machine, the computer? Written by DC Fontana, The Ultimate Computer explores the complex relationship between man and machine. Although we initially embrace our new inventions, we secretly live in fear of them taking over. But exactly how much faith do we put in a computer? Will the computer equivalent of the steam drill replace Kirk the way it did John Henry? Well, we all know the answer to that one. Unlike John Henry, James T. Kirk will not die with his hammer in his hand. Let the battle between Kirk and the ultimate computer begin. When do you think the first modern computer was designed? The 1920s? The 30s? How about the 1830s? The credit goes to an English mathematician and inventor, Charles Babbage, who called his mechanical marvel an analytical engine. The first computer-like device to use electricity didn't come along until 1939, followed by UNIVAC in 1946, which was the first truly practical computer. Today, we've got the PC and the Mac, and perhaps someday we'll have a Deep Blue or a HAL. Well, maybe not a HAL. If you've seen 2001, A Space Odyssey, you know how notoriously untrustworthy they can be. Dr. Richard Daystrom learned an important lesson in humility. We create out of conceit. It's human nature to do so. We believe we can make anything better and faster, stronger, cheaper, more beautiful, more profitable, something more original. We've created computers that think, and we create children that achieve. But in the end, what we create is always a mirror of our own nature, and that nature, as wonderful and as complex as it is fallible. So, don't trust in chariots, but enjoy the ride, and remember, always back up your hard drive.